whether momos have replaced the staple North Indian or Indian samosa snack as the next new snack and a street food.
It's very high in glycemic index also, which easily shoots up your blood glucose. And we can see nowadays there are lots of problems like obesity, diabetes, hypertension, all because of these maida products.
Unhealthy eating, we want something quick, so we go out on the street and, you know, quickly buy some samosa. Nobody actually takes the effort to prepare these things at home.
The chutneys they use are made up of monosodium glutamate. The Chinese are majorly of monosodium glutamate, which is very high in sodium. And this is the major problem that occurs due to these hypertension and all.
These momos can be made with variety of fillings. They can have a variety of taste. So, you know, while the dietitian point may be right that, you know, both are unhealthy, but comparing the two, I think the current fad is towards moving towards momos.
They are using the left out of the vegetable, left out of the meat and all the stuffing they are using.
Momos are steamed. So if our point is, you know, using leftover vegetables. So is leftover vegetable wrong?
You won't believe, it's a carcinogenic agent that produce after a second use of that same one.
In a serving size of around 169 grams, it contains only about 12.4 grams of fat.
You can go for a bhel puri chaat without any imli chutney and all the tamarind chutneys.
Great.
And another thing, we can go for a without cheese sandwiches, which is easy to prepare and it's very good to have and it's very healthy option.